Now, I've got this little test for you. Here we are. Right. And with any luck, the audience might have some bubble wrap too. They're waving their bubble wrap. Thank you, audience. Do not pop it. This is a really important exercise.
So what do you mean, don't pop it?
Don't pop it. Do not. No. This is really important.
Okay, okay.
No problem.
This is a test of your worthiness. Don't pop it yet.
One of mine's already popped. I didn't do it.
No, that's all right. As long as you did. Because in 2013, a group of Yale psychologists, they found another use for bubble wrap, which was to measure aggression. All right? They showed pictures of cute animals, all right? And were...
Wait.
Stop it. People were told to pop bubble wrap as they watched. They thought that it was a test for their motor activity and memory. But in fact, it was a test for what's called cute aggression. If you see something very cute, you start popping more and more. Not because they wanted to hurt the animals, but because they were frustrated at not being able to touch them and cuddle them. And this is called cute aggression. It's when you kind of go, oh, like that. So, audience, hold your bubble wrap. We're going to show you some very cute animals, and it's all up to you.
OK.
Let's start with the cuteness.
Oh, dear.
That's not... Come on, that's not that cute.
It's not that cute.
He's not that cute. I think he's been shot.
That is horrible.
He does look like he's been shot.
Oh, the blue eyed.
No. Not that cute. Not worth a pop.
Yeah, that's getting quite a few pops.
Look at his little eye.
No, I'm not done yet. I want a dog and then I'm going to pop my load.
That's the first time I've heard that phrase since last night.
Oh, the...
That's pretty cute.
That was the last one.
Not cute, Ginger.